And welcome to Trinity Anglican Church. This is the third Sunday of Advent. And this being the Sunday that we do the Lessons and Carols service, which is a very beautiful service, and I can't wait to hear the choir, as you can see, there's lots of things that are set up here. So we're in for a real treat. And before we do that, we have the honor of lighting our Advent candles. And we have some wonderful torch lighters here with us, as they would say in England, torch lighters.
The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to bring good tidings to the afflicted.
O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captives Israel, that mourns in lowly exile here, until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel, come again.
Last Sunday, the candle of peace was lit. We light it and the candle of hope again as we remember that Christ will come again and bring to the world everlasting peace. The third candle of Advent is the candle of joy. It reminds of the joy that Mary felt when the angel Gabriel told her that a special child would be born to her, a child who would save and deliver his people.
The angel who announced to the shepherds that Jesus had been born, "Do not be afraid. I am bringing you good news of great joy. For to you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord."
We light this candle to remember that Christ brings the promise of a new life, a life in which the blind receive sight, the lame walk, and the prisoners are set free. We light this candle to remember that he is the bringer of true and everlasting joy.
A candle is burning, a candle of joy, a candle to welcome brave Mary's new boy. Our hearts fill with wonder and eyes light and glow as joy brightens winter like sunshine on snow. Loving Father, we thank you for the joy you bring us. Help us prepare our hearts for this gift that we may hear and to do your word. We ask it in the name of the one born in Bethlehem. Amen.
Thank you.
The God of power and mercy, you call us once again to celebrate the coming of your Son. Remove those things which hinder love of you, that when he comes, he may find us waiting in awe and wonder. For him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior has taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please remain seated.
chapter of Genesis, beginning at the 8th verse. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid, because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent beguiled me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." The word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
The second lesson is written in the 22nd chapter of Genesis, beginning at the 15th verse. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you. And I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies, and by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The third lesson is written in the ninth chapter of Isaiah, beginning at the second verse. The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. And they rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as with people who exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden, and the bar across their shoulders, and the rod of their oppressor, you have broken, as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors, and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire.
child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And join me in prayer 82.
Thank you. of Micah, beginning at the second verse. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel, and he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. And this is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
lesson is written in the first chapter of Luke, beginning at the 26th verse. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting that might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
lesson is written in the first chapter of Matthew, beginning at the 18th verse. Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All of this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Seventh lesson is to be found in the Gospel according to St. Luke in chapter 2, beginning at the 8th verse. "And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be for all people. For unto you is born this day, small print, sorry, in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them unto heaven, the shepherds said one to each other, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, and which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. chapter of the Gospel according to Matthew. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of King Herod, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he and all in Jerusalem were frightened. And he called together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, and inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for this has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who will govern my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for those three wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. So he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, that I may also go and worship him." When they had heard their king, they set out, and there, lo, ahead of them, with the star that they had seen at its rising, and until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with great joy. Upon entering the stable, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold and of frankincense and of myrrh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The ninth lesson is written in the first chapter of John, beginning at the first verse. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was light, and the light was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet, the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of man, or the will of the flesh, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our offertory carol will be number 77, Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Thank you.
Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel, forever and ever. All that is in the heaven and the earth is thine. All things are thine, and thou art our own, and have we given thee. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord, may we all stand in awe of the greatest gift ever given to humankind. Let us, this Advent, prepare ourselves for the coming of the Messiah once again this Christmas. Amen. O Lord Jesus Christ, who at thy first coming did send the messenger to prepare the way before thee, grant that the ministers and stewards of thy mysteries may likewise so prepare and make ready thy way, by turning the hearts of the disobedient to the wisdom of the just, that at thy second coming to judge the world, we may be found an acceptable people in thy sight, who livest and reignest with the Father and the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Christ, by his incarnation, gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, grant you the fullness of inward peace and goodwill, and make you partakers of thy divine nature. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be on you and those of whom we pray for this day and always. Amen. We'll join together in the carol 361, Joy to the World. Thanks be to God.